Hey everybody, it's Charles from HumbleMechanic.com. Today we're going to be replacing the seat adjustment cable on the R32. The cable we're going to be replacing today is the one that allows you to move the seat forward and back. This cable usually fails in one of two ways. Either the plastic retention tabs break, which is what happened here, or the pin seizes due to oxidation. Today, I'm going to show you how to fix both of them. If the pin is seized, oftentimes you can remove it, clean it, lubricate it, and reinstall it, and it may work just fine. The tools we're going to need for this job will be a 13mm socket, a 10mm socket, a ratchet and extension, a T20 Torx, or a Phillips head screwdriver, a torque wrench, and something like this pick. If your seat has side airbags, according to the repair manual, you will need to disconnect the vehicle battery because we'll be unplugging the airbag. To do that, simply remove the battery cover, use your 10mm socket, and disconnect the negative terminal of the battery. While you don't have to remove the seat from the vehicle, it does make it quite a bit easier to replace this cable, and so I can shoot a better video for you guys. That's what we're going to do. First thing I like to do is remove the floor mats from the car. Next, if you can, slide the seat all the way forward. We'll need to remove the plastic trim covering the seat rails. If your plastic trim has these little caps, use your pick to pop the cap loose. As you can see, these are pretty well damaged, so be really careful doing this. Once you have those caps out, take out the T20 or the Phillips head screws, depending on what year your car is. Some of the older models had a Phillips head rather than a T20. For the trim covering the inside rail, lift up on the back of it and slide it back and up. This can be really challenging if you can't slide the seat all the way forward, so be extra careful because this plastic may also be very brittle. For the trim covering the outside rail, lift up on the back, push it gently forward just a little bit, and then lift it straight out. Next, if you can, slide the seat all the way back. There are two 13mm fasteners holding the front of the seat to the car. If this is a Golf Beetle or Jetta, they're going to be nuts. If this is a Passat, they're going to be bolts. Once you have those fasteners removed, gently tap the seat back. This will push it out of the bracket holding it to the car. Next, we want to lift up on the front of the seat and go in and unplug any connectors. On my car, we have three, one for the seatbelt latch switch, one for the heated seats, and one for the side airbag. Remember that the yellow connectors are going to be your airbag system connectors. Before removing the seat, I like to lay a towel over the door sill trim to protect it from getting scratched. In order to get the seat out, you need to slide it as far back as it'll go. There are wheels at the back lower portion of the seat frame that need to be pushed out of the channel in the car. Once those are out of the channel, we can lift the seat up and out. The easiest way to pick the seat up is to slide one hand between the bottom cushion and the backrest and hold it there, and then put your other hand at the front of the seat and lift it up and out. Be really careful not to scratch any of the interior with the seat frame. Once you have the seat out, lay a towel down or something and lay the seat back so we have the bottom of it exposed. We're gonna need to remove this screw right here and take the handle off. Now we can pull the cable up and forward and out of its retainer. And for me, I have to cut a few zip ties. Next, we're gonna need to remove the cable from the sliding piece on the seat. It's really only held in by this one metal clip. You do need to slightly pry the clip apart in order to get it out. The housing is technically adjustable, and you could get kinda crazy and break out the caliper to take this measurement, but putting a small mark on it to get it close is really good enough here. Once the clip is removed, we need to press these two tabs on the plastic housing, and then we can remove the cable. You can see here the lock pin has a little bit of debris on it, but nothing major. To clean the channel where the lock pin rides, roll up a small piece of fine grit sandpaper, spray it with that 3-in-1 lock dry lube, and clean it out as best you can. Doing this will help protect against any future corrosion, and it won't attract any dirt. Normally, this is something that I'll use in an ignition switch because it works fantastic there, but this is another really great application for it. If you're trying to salvage the old cable, use that same fine grit sandpaper, spray it with 3-in-1 lock dry lube, and clean the pin. Be sure to make it as smooth as possible, but you really don't want to remove any metal, only debris or oxidation. Now that the slider is all cleaned and lubricated, it's time to reinstall the cable. Simply push the plastic housing through, make sure the pin goes all the way in, put the clip back on. Next, we're going to route our cable. Notice that it has to loop around this way in order to not hit any of these connectors. Next, we need to snap the plastic retaining tabs into the seat. This can be a little bit tricky, they're pretty tight, so you might need a screwdriver or a pair of pliers to lock the tabs in. Just be really careful because you don't want to break your brand new cable. Next, slide the end piece of the cable up and through so that it sits in the bracket where the handle attaches. Go ahead and put the handle back on. Pull the handle a few times and make sure that the seat slider releases. Probably a good idea to hit it one more time with that 3-in-1 before putting the seat back in. And if you're feeling frisky, this is an awesome time to go ahead and vacuum up the carpet or clean the seat. Next, let's put that seat back in. Go ahead and throw your towel over the door sill if you removed it. We're gonna put the seat back in the same way we took it out, set it in the car, and make sure the rollers go back in the tracks on both sides. Once that's done, go ahead and tilt the seat back a little bit and make sure you plug in all your connectors as well as clip this plastic tab into place. This will prevent any wiring from getting pinched in the seat track. I like to start these 13 millimeters by hand. Once they're started, you can slide the seat all the way back to make it a little easier to access. Snug those 13 millimeter nuts down and torque them to 23 newton meters. Now, slide the seat all the way forward, move to the back, go ahead and put your plastic covers back on. Remember, on the inner one, there's a tab that needs to slide into place at the front. Put your screws back in, be it the T20s or the Phillips head, and if your car had them, snap the plastic covers back in. Next, slide your seat back and forth a bunch of times, run it through all the adjustment to be sure that everything works properly. If you removed them, go ahead and put your floor mats back in, reconnect your vehicle battery, don't forget to set the clock and the pinch protection, and guys, that's all you gotta do. All right, guys, I'm gonna wrap it up there. Questions, comments, go down below. If you like the video, hit that thumbs up button. Don't forget to subscribe. Big ups to 3-in-1 for supplying the Lock Dry Lube and sponsoring this video. You can follow me on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and of course on Snapchat. As always, links to everything we use today are down in the description. Guys, thanks so much for watching, and I will see you next time.